Here beginneth the first verse of the third chapter of the book of Genesis. Now the serpent was more subtle than any other wild creature that the Lord God had made. He said to the woman, "Did God say, 'You shall not eat of any tree in the garden?'" And the woman said to the serpent, "We may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but God said, 'You shall not eat of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, neither shall you touch it, lest you die.'" But the serpent said to the woman, "You will not die, for God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." So when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was a delight to the eyes, and that the tree was to be desired to make one wise, she took of its fruit and ate. And she also gave some to her husband, and he ate. Then the eyes of both were opened, and they knew that they were naked. And they sewed fig leaves together and made themselves aprons. And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord, from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" And he said, "I heard the sound of thee in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." He said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten of the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman whom thou gavest to be with me, she gave me fruit of the tree, and I ate." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent beguiled me, and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you above all cattle and above all wild animals. Upon your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel." Here endeth the lesson.
Thank you. Here beginneth the first verse of the fourth chapter of the Epistle of St. Paul to the Galatians. I mean that the heir, as long as he is a child, is no better than a slave, though he is the owner of all the estate. But he is under guardians and trustees until the date set by the father. So with us, when we were children, we were slaves to the elemental spirits of the universe. But when the time had fully come, God sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as sons. And because you are sons, God has sent the spirit of his son into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. So through God, you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then an heir. Here endeth the lesson.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We seek your aid, O Holy Mother of God. Despise not our petitions and our necessities, but deliver us from all dangers, O ever glorious and blessed Virgin. Blessed woman, who with the disciples received the Holy Spirit, pray for us. Blessed woman, completing thy work on earth, pray for us. Blessed woman, welcomed into the joys of heaven, pray for us. Blessed woman, crowned with beauty and light, pray for us. Mary, of whom the angels sing, pray for us. Mary, daughter of Israel, pray for us. Mary, strength of martyrs, pray for us. Mary, hope of the poor, pray for us. Mary, standing in the glorious company of apostles, pray for us. Thou, O Mary, hast perfectly fulfilled the will of the Heavenly Father. Thy greatest honor and blessedness is not to have been the mother only, but the disciple of Christ. Blessed art thou to have heard the word of God, and to have kept it within thy heart. Thou didst harbor the truth of Christ in thine understanding, even more than his human flesh in thy womb. Thou art the beauty and dignity of earth, O blessed Virgin Mary. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Amen. Almighty God, for every triumph of the Spirit, we give thee thanks. For all the joys which beauty creates, and for that joy we know in the creation of beauty. For all the joys of truth, and for the joy we know in the struggle with mystery and the unknown. For the joy of the hands at work, or at prayer, or at play. For the joy of the seeing eye and the understanding heart and the creative spirit. For the joy of struggle and the joy of rest. For the joy of deeds and the joy of dreams out of which they come. For all these joys and others such as any of us may know, we give thee thanks through Jesus Christ, the bringer of glad news. Amen.
Thank you.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Blessed be the Mother of God, Mary Most Holy.
Blessed be the Mother of God, Mary Most Holy.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be
Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.
Blessed be